games the rest of the season, a little bit of John with the Montana bench and stuff. Was there anything specific going on out there?
Not really. I just know the coach and Ahmad Rory on the team that wasn't suited up today.
Right from the get-go, you guys were playing your tempo. What was the biggest factor in just being able to push the pace tonight?
We just get out and run and try to have fun in the beginning of the game and kind of just come out fast and keep it going for 40 minutes.
Marquise, what was the plan against Martin?
Just don't let him catch the ball. If he catches the ball, we get, I forgot what it's called. But you come baseline and help, and then you just recover back. And you just play one-on-one and kind of sag off and let him shoot because he wants to go left.
Did you sense that there was some frustration with him after maybe the first couple fouls?
Yeah, I can see that he was getting frustrated, but any competitor kind of gets mad when you're not playing up to your own expectations. So I don't blame him, but he's a good player.
And how about for you? Did you have a sense that you were going to come out and you were going to score well today?
Oh, no, I couldn't really tell. I was just feeling good. I was shooting the ball well, getting to the free throw line.
You only had one foul today.
Surprising.
Yeah. Something you did or just...
No, I don't really think it was a conscious effort not to do anything. I was just playing, and it just happened that way. I was kind of just playing, I wouldn't say less aggressive, but just more conservative to where it was like, I could kind of give this up here, and I could go get this block, or I have to let this one go instead of getting a foul and end up coming out of the game. You know what I mean?
Did it allow you to get in your rhythm a little bit more? Did it allow you to get in your rhythm a little bit more knowing that you could play free because you weren't in foul trouble?
Yeah, it just made me feel more comfortable. Like, I didn't have to worry about coming out and coming back in and worrying about, like, picking up where I left off. I kind of just kept it going.
Were you surprised about the technical?
No. I mean, he stepped on my stomach, but it is what it is. I was on the ground. He was trying to run back. So.
What about for hanging on the rim?
Oh. I mean... I'll take the consequence for that. We were just having fun.
Yeah.
It was a little extra, but things happen.
DeJounte, what goes into when you got it in the open floor, unless you turn back and let him know you're going to throw it off the glass, what goes into the decision there?
I'm pretty sure he knew I was going to throw it off the glass or bounce it back to him or something. That's just coming from me being unselfish and, like, you see my teammates, you know, happy and have fun and stuff. And, I mean, open court, I just do it up. And we practice it all the time. It was just the time, right place, and it happened.
Is that called much? That particular hanging on the rim?
I wouldn't say it was that I held on the rim. I think it's because when I pulled up, my head was above the rim.
Oh, okay.
So it was kind of excessive.
But right.
Yeah.
It was fun, though.
Yeah.
And even though those plays are only worth 2 points, is it more than that? I mean, is it getting the other players involved, the fans involved?
I just feel like by doing that, it's a highlight play. And it got, you know, the fans on their feet, got them going crazy. And, I mean, as long as they're having fun, it's cool. I'm cool with it. And I'm pretty sure Coach is cool with it. He wasn't mad about it. I think he was mad about hanging on the rim.
Yeah.
But like you say, you're going to take the consequences for it.
I mean, it's more of like when that happens, just the emotion in the gym changes, and it's kind of like, it's in our favor that we're changing the tempo of the game and we're going how we want to play. And I just think that helps us because we're a running team, so then that plays in our hand.
And it seemed as if the entire second half was that way. Like, you guys were just looking for everything. You know, every pass, just trying to get out.
Yeah, that's how we play mostly. We just look for a long pass and run. That's how our team would play. We run the floor, we spread the floor, and just get to the rim.
Hey, baby boy, is it kind of a hallmark of your best games when you've got a little bit of everything in the stat column, you know, just some points, some rebounds, some assists, some steals. Is that when you know you're kind of at your best?
Yeah, I mean, every game I just try to come out and play my game, you know, and my game is just working hard and making other people better, and just everything else will fall into place.
With these fast starts you guys have had, where does that energy come from? Like, what happens during warm-ups or during pregame that kind of gets you guys on that same page energy-wise?
I think, you know, like, every game we take it one game at a time, and coaches tell us, jump out first. Don't let them come off and come hot first. You know, we go out and play our game, and our game is a high-intense team, and just going out, playing hard, working hard, and we just got to keep it up, take it one game at a time.
After a game